Hello everyone, my name is Artem Sanakoev and in this video we will talk how to win a prize in a Kaggle competition, namely Lyft motion prediction for autonomous vehicles. This competition was organized by Lyft and has recently finished. At the final test phase, me and my team, including Dmitro Baplavsky and Artem Zhivalkovsky, secured the third place and we won $6,000 in prize. To see how we came up with our winning solution, let's begin! Lyft used a fleet of the cars equipped with lidars and cameras to collect a large dataset. They were driving for more than 1000 hours along the streets of San Francisco and scanned the environment around the cars. The lidars and cameras are used to obtain 3D point clouds, which are then processed to detect all the surrounding objects, other cars, pedestrians, cyclists, road signs, and so on. Then all the objects can be registered on the map using GPS and the corresponding 3D coordinates. It is important to record a lot of trips to cover very diverse road situations. As you can see here, the perception task is pretty much solved and the current Lyft's pipeline shows fairly robust results. However, the motion prediction of all the agents on the road, I mean other cars, pedestrians and cyclists, and planning of the future actions of the autonomous vehicle are still very challenging problems. In this competition, we had to tackle the motion prediction task. We are given an agent and its travel history, which was collected as I have just described. The history and the current road situation is represented as a multi-channel image by means of rendering all the given data. The task is to predict 3 hypothetical trajectories for 50 time steps in future. What you always should do in any Kaggle competition is to start with a simple baseline model. And it turned out for us that the simplest baseline worked the best and it became the core of our solution. It is a simple CNN which takes an input image and predicts 3 trajectories with the corresponding confidence. Of course, as a common practice, we experimented with different CNN backbones. Among the best performing were exception 41, exception 71, exception 65 and efficient net B5. As the loss, we directly optimize the target metric, negative log likelihood of the ground truth coordinate. Given the ground truth and k predicted trajectories, we compute the likelihood of the ground truth trajectory under the mixture of Gaussians with the means equal to the k predicted trajectories and the identity matrix as a covariant. And this can be further decomposed into the product of one-dimensional Gaussians and we get just a log sum of the exponent. Beyond the model with 3 output trajectories, as you can see here, we also trained a model with 16 hypotheses, which result in more diverse predictions. For example, both left turn and turn around are plausible in the situation on the image. And the 16 output model predicts this in contrast to the previous model with 3 outputs. We used default rasterization parameters provided by the organizers and produced images of 224 by 224 pixels. Important detail which improved our training efficiency is using a sparse set of 4 history time steps, 1, 2, 4 and 8 ticks in the past. We did not notice any improvement of the target metric score when using more history time steps. One of the major speed bottlenecks in the pipeline was image rasterization. The default rasterizer is pretty slow and produces around 15 images per second on a single CPU core. We cached the rasterized images to disk as compressed MPZ files, and during training we just loaded them from disk instead of costly online rasterization. This resulted in 7 times speedup and we could read more than 100 images per second using a single process. Another important step was to start using the full training dataset, which contains more than 1000 hours of driving. To remove highly correlated samples, we selected only every 8th frame for every agent in the dataset. This reduced the epoch training time and the disk space required for caching the dataset from 10 terabytes to 1.3 terabytes. For the core model, it was crucial to find a proper learning rate schedule. We used stochastic gradient descent with relatively high learning rate of 0.01 and a cosine annealing scheduler with warm restarts, where where the length of every next cycle was gradually increased. Another important trick was grading clipping, which stabilized training, especially at the initial epoch. Significant score improvement was achieved after we allowed training samples to be without history at all. This increased training complexity and improved the model generalization on validation and test sets. We trained each model for around a week on a single GPU. Our best model was based on exception 41. It achieved a validation score of 1037, which corresponds to the 5th place at the leaderboard. Training for longer is likely to improve the score. Our final ensemble consists of 7 models, 3 different versions with exception 41 backbone, exception 65, exception 71 and efficient net B5. And we also have one model based on exception 41 with 16 output hypotheses. This model can generate very diverse trajectories and is very useful in the ensemble. By running inference on all these models, we get in total 34 hypotheses and their confidences. But we are allowed to submit only 3 final hypotheses for evaluation. And one of the most challenging parts of this competition is how to combine multiple hypotheses to produce only 3 required for the evaluation. Obviously, it is beneficial to select very diverse proposals as it increases the chance that one of them will be close to the ground truth. One can see that such a problem statement is closely related to a well-known non-maximum suppression method widely used in object detection pipelines, where multiple spurious detections have to be filtered. The trivial way to do non-maximum suppression is a greedy algorithm. We iteratively select the most confident detections while suppressing very similar but less confident ones. We can apply a similar greedy approach to our task. However, this greedy algorithm doesn't work well for our task. We tried another approach. We applied k-means clustering with 3 clusters to the pool of 34 hypotheses and used their centroids as the final predictions. However, this didn't work well neither. Another attempt was to compute weighted average of the clusters using the confidences as weights. Unfortunately, neither of these methods could outperform the best single model. We speculate that the discrete nature of greedy non-maximum suppression and k-means significantly limit the possible solution space. To combat these shortcomings, we consider an extension of the non-maximum suppression to the continuous case, and this naturally leads us to the Gaussian mixture model. We fit a mixture of 3 Gaussians to the pool of the hypotheses and use the obtained means of the Gaussians as the final predictions. The optimized objective is very similar to the traditional Gaussian mixture model objective. It is log likelihood of the input hypothesis. The only modification to the original Gaussian mixture model objective is that every hypothesis is weighted according to its confidence. This approach works pretty well and produces solution better than any single model in the ensemble, but it can easily get stuck in local optima and is very sensitive to the initialization. To further improve the results, we implemented a neural network model which optimizes this loss and can produce a solution in a single forward pass. The important property which we require of this neural network is to be permutational invariant for input hypotheses, because our hypotheses do not have any particular order. In other words, a neural network has to take a set of hypotheses as input and produce 3 final trajectories. As the model satisfying our needs, we select a set transformer. Set transformer has an encoder which takes input hypotheses and their confidences and applies 2 self-attention blocks to them to produce a feature vectors which encode all pairwise relations between the input hypotheses. Next, the first block of the decoder takes 3 learnable seed vectors which represent the prototypes for our 3 output trajectories and attend to the most relevant representations of the input hypothesis from the encoder. Next follows another self-attention block, after which we produce 3 output trajectories and the corresponding confidences. This transformer is invariant to the permutations of the input and it doesn't utilize a positional encoding. Essentially, it takes a lot of trajectories as inputs and outputs 3 new ones that describe the input in the best possible way. Such a model can leverage global statistics of the entire training dataset, whereas Gaussian mixture and clustering do not have a global context and work sample-wise. Our transformer can also be trained in a supervised fashion using the same laws which we use for our first-level CNN models. In this case, transformer performs on par with the Gaussian mixture. But the best validation score is achieved by unsupervised training merely on the validation set. The same holds for unsupervised training on the test set. As a conclusion, I would like to say several things. It was very important to optimize the rasterizer to train faster. A simple CNN regression baseline turned out to be the best model and is very hard to beat. As always, keep it simple. Training for longer with right parameters on the entire dataset was crucial. Set transformer can be used for model ensembling, and it lifted our team to the third place. Thank you guys, let me know in comments what you think about this video, and have a happy kaggling!